Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome along to Croke Park Stadium in Dublin. All-Ireland Senior Hurling Final Day. It is Limerick, the 3-in-a-row champions, going for 4-in-a-row against the Cats of Kilkenny. Donn O'Sullivan here in commentary alongside me, as always, for these big occasions. Former Limerick captain, James Ryan. James, the team's marching around behind the band. We'll name them out in 2 minutes' time, but just tell us, for those people just tuning in, the rain has kind of pushed away, the lights are on. Windy day here in Croke Park, with ideal conditions for hurling so far.
Yeah, I suppose if people want a brief outline of the day so far, there was no game on before, so it's fairly dead. I think a lot of people didn't bother coming in until just about before throwing, because there was nothing else really going on. It was raining as well. So now it's a full house here. Nothing like Croke Park All-Ireland Hurling Final Day. Yeah, two teams going around the parade, and I actually thought, I was trying to give them some tactical knowledge there at the start, that Tom Phelan was going out in the middle of the field, because I couldn't figure it out. But it was actually TJ Reid didn't join the parade until halfway around it. He was getting his boot fixed, something. But arguably one of the greatest hurlers of the time, he probably doesn't need to join the parade now he's gone up in that boat. So yeah, look, both teams look quite kind of, I know I contradict myself, kind of edgy, but cool, calm and collected in another way, if that makes sense.
Yeah, Kilkenny team, Owen Murphy in goals, in front of him Mikey Butler, Hugh Lawler and Tommy Walsh. One change in the team, with David Blanchfield with a collapsed lung, we believe, missing out. Walter Walsh replaces him. Richie Reid wears number 6, while Paddy Deegan wears number 7. In midfield, it's Conor Fogarty and Adrian Mullen, for the time being at least. Tom Phelan, Martin Keogh and John Donnelly in the half-forward line, while the full-forward line of Billy Ryan, TJ Reid and Owen Cody will take some watching. The Limerick team, Mickey Quaid in goals, in front of him Mike Casey, Dan Morrissey and Barry Nash, Jamer Burns, William O'Donoghue and Kyle Hayes, while Darrow O'Donovan joins the captain Cian Lynch in midfield. Gerard Hegarty, David Reedy and Tom Morrissey are on the 40, while the full forward line of Aaron Galland, Seamus Flanagan and Peter Casey going to take some minding of their own. No Sean Finn, no Declan Hannan, no Richie English, and as we mentioned there, Kilkenny with no David Blanchfield. All-Ireland Final Days, Declan Hannan flashes up on the big screen there. Tough day for him. He won't mind if a man in a green jersey goes up the steps of the Hogan Stand.
Yeah, it's always a disappointing day. Look, down at the end of the day, you go at the start of the year. Your plan is at the end of the year to be playing, and if not winning All-Ireland Final, but it's definitely to play. So anyone that misses out on the big day, the big occasion with the champ all year, very disappointing. Whether you have 10 of them, whether you have 11 of them, whether you've captained the 4 times, whatever it is, it's very disappointing. But look, as you say, the team has to move on. That sport, he physically can't play. Either can Jimmy Quilty, either can Richie English. They're out. They can't twist and turn, they can't run, they're out. That's the nature of sport. And again, Don, to look to number 1 to 15, you just called them out. We still look like a strong team down in paper, obviously.
The Limerick team remain behind the band as the Artane band make their way around. Kilkenny have broken off. Coverage, as always, on Live 95 is brought to you by Limerick Motor Centre, your main high-end dealer in the Valley Simon Road. Well, growing up, every single one of us would have sat down on Sunday afternoon. It was the first Sunday in September for so many years. The minor final was on Osgoelga, and then the senior one served up at 3:30. So Limerick looked like they're going to play against the wind in the first half here. James Ryan, 086-123-9595 to WhatsApp us, which has already been done by Ross, Audrey, Charlie, Archie, Bonnie and Harvey. And also a shout out to Suzanne Hickey, who's celebrating her 40th birthday. I met her on the way in, and also this morning in the Bewley's Cafe. I went in for a cup of coffee, James, and the girl behind the counter said she's one of the Hayes from Doon. Very so good. Limerick have invaded Dublin en masse. They're finishing their warm up down below us. Looking away to the left hand side, I see that Ireland is currently celebrating 175 years of our Irish flag, and they're asking people to respect the national anthem until its completion. Well, that's not going to happen, because one of the traditions, James, as you know better than most, is that Shalliv Conagher on the Vian is often crowded out by loud noises. So the Artane band are on the Vian on Ireland Final Day. Where would you rather be? the Cats of Kilkenny looking for their 37th All-Ireland, Limerick looking for their 12th. They're 4 in a row. We won't worry about that, James Ryan, because as we said earlier, people don't come out of retirement for these things. And looking down below us, Limerick to play from right to left in their green and white, Kilkenny in the black and amber. The man in the middle is referee John Keenan, the man that refereed the Munster Hurling final last season and got plenty of stick for leaving it flow. We hope it leaves it flow today. Limerick on the attack from the first ball from Darragh Donovan in towards the edge of the square. Galland tries to get it, can't fix it away, and it's the first 50-50 ball. Galan almost won it. Kilkenny coming away. And if you wanted to know what the Limerick tactics are, James Ryan, we've seen him ball out over the sideline. Limerick in, putting pressure on. It's going to be a sideline ball to Limerick. Straight as you want, direct as you want. Feed Aaron Galan, and he'll get you a score.
Yeah, and just I suppose tactically, what we were hearing was right. John Donnelly has gone out to the middle of the field. Conor Foley's gone back to wing back. And Walter Welch starting, and Dermot Burns like for like there. Half back, half forward. So an interesting matchups.
Darragh Donovan down below us, taking the sideline ball in towards Peter Casey. Mitch Sturgeon hands it TJ Reid for Kilkenny, spinning around the blue and white helmet out the field as we expected him to play into centre halfback Richie Reid and out the far side. Plenty of space out there too for the first shot at goal of the day from Paddy Deegan. Is the wind going to carry it over the bar? It is over the bar, and the first score of the afternoon is for Kilkenny, and it's Paddy Deegan.
Yeah, and have no doubt about it, Kilkenny are learning from playing against Limerick obviously last year, and they just learned from watching the Munster Championship, and that you have to play with which your wing forwards have, wing backs have to get up and act like wing forwards. Paddy Deegan done it there. Great score to Kilkenny, but don't be shocked at half time if Kilkenny do go a couple of points in ahead, because there's a very strong window down, as you're after saying.
Yeah, Keane Lynch there getting the first ball off the sharp puck out in towards William O'Donoghue. Short to him, looking for Galan. He's behind his man this time, beaten to it, and then picked up off the ground. Referee says it's a free out. Galan had it in his hand, and just looking in there trying to make out the numbers, it looks it is. Like Hugh Lawler is picking up Aaron Galan. He likes to do that job on him, but Limerick went short with the first puck out.
Yeah, went short, but into the maze in here, maybe it just plays out differently, it looks differently in Croke Park. But isn't Hugh Lawler totally isolated inside Aaron Galan? The way Limerick are able to make space, it must be fair to for any full back. But look, Hugh Lawler's doing well. Aaron Galan did pick it up off the ground, just have seen the replay there. But Hugh Lawler's after 2-0 there, winning it twice now already.
William O'Donoghue, the free man. Mike Casey goes out to win it against Martin Keogh. William O'Donoghue wins it, wrestled to the ground by Walter Walsh, and the free go to Limerick.
Yeah, look, I suppose it's an edgy start from both teams. The game definitely hasn't settled down yet, but it's amazing as well. Somebody must be coming out there. I'd say Martin Keown must be, or one of the Kilkenny full forward line must be coming out a bit. And it looks like Limerick are playing a sweep, because Barry Nash has been, I know there's only 2 minutes gone, but he's been relatively free for in the backs for most of the game so far.
Yeah, he's also taken this free from down under the Hogan stand, drills it into the wind down on top of Peter Casey. Can he pick it up? Temperature dropping here as the sun has gone in. Still Kilkenny 1 point, Limerick no score. Back there for Kilkenny is John Donnelly, as mentioned by James Ryan, playing right half back. This one brought out by Hugh Lawler. 50-50 ball down in front of Barry Nash, I should say, and Martin Keown. Martin Keown wins it, plays it in towards the middle, dropped inside, picked up again though by Tom Phelan, spinning it around out here towards Adrian Mullen. Adrian Mullen blocked down by Darragh Donovan, and the ball goes back, and Kyle Hayes is in a foot race back there with Phelan. Kyle Hayes doesn't get it up cleanly towards Barry Nash. Hand is up, can't get the hand free, and a sideline ball to Kilkenny. And Kilkenny looking to sharper, 3 minutes in, still 1 point and no score.
Yeah, and what you mean by sharper as well is probably nearly hungrier. Darragh Donovan seemed to block that ball down. I don't know whether Barry Nash and William O'Donoghue thought the other person had it or whatever, but Kyle, they were all very kind of gingerly going over to the ball. So look, maybe a very slow start out of Limerick. Kilkenny obviously are looking to bring that massive work rate desire, and they've started that way.
TJ Reid goes short with it. Sideline ball, 1-2, gets it back, half blocked down by Mike Casey. I'm behind that one. That looks like it's going to go over the bar. They're going to go to Hawkeye. No, they're not. They're going to go wide.
My God, that wasn't far off, Don. That would have been one of the greatest scores I've ever seen in Croke Park. He probably shouldn't have took the shot on, but he wasn't far off for a finish.
Interesting that Mike Casey lined up at left cornerback. Barry Nash going over right. Ball down on top of Tom Morrissey on his own, surrounded by three Kilkenny men. Nicky Quaid finds him and he loses possession. As mentioned, Kilkenny winning the 50-50 so far. Garrod Hegarty chases this ball down, but again a free man for Kilkenny. The ball not sticking, much like the start of last year's All-Ireland final. But Kilkenny motoring down this near side. Shot at the goal from way up by Walter Walsh. It's going to bounce into the hands, hopefully, of Nicky Quaid. Can't pick it up the first time, picks it the second time. And out here, thankfully for Limerick people listening all over the world, towards Kyle Hayes. Kyle Hayes half locked down, or hooked as he was going for it. Now went towards Garrod Hegarty. 4 minutes gone, ball out over the sideline. And Limerick well off the pace, it must be said, in the opening couple of minutes. But well, we've been here before, 4.5 minutes gone, and a low scoring game people will tell you will suit Kilkenny.
Yeah, and I agree with you totally, and we can only go on what we see. They look a little bit off the pace. They look a little bit like tired and not going after the ball. Just got blocked down there, but again, they're just trying to play themselves into game. I'm sure there was nerves there at the start.
Darragh O'Donovan gets it towards William O'Donoghue. Now off towards the captain, Cian Lynch, and over the bar. The first score of the afternoon for Limerick from Cian Lynch. 5 minutes gone.
Yeah, and that could be one of the most important scores of the game, Don, as you say, because if that rock kind of continued there, and often it takes a score, some bit of brilliance there. Great score, Cian Lynch hit the ball as clean as a whistle. Well, the Welsh done the complete opposite here. It was nearly a goal chance, Kilkenny, but a great score to Cian Lynch. Evens it up with 5 minutes gone, 1 point each.
1-2 with the fullback for Kilkenny. Into the hands of Murphy, launches it long down towards Big Dan. Dan puts the hand up, can't kick it. Kicks it out in front of himself, down towards Cian Lynch. Up goes the hand again from Dan Morrissey, nearly taken off in there by William O'Donoghue. Ball breaks out the far side, Kilkenny have it. Shot a goal from Owen Cody, the captain of Kilkenny, and that has gone to the left and wide, two wides for Kilkenny. None so far for Limerick. Nicky Quayle had the ball in the hands of Darragh O'Donovan, and the referee said that's too quick, and that can be a thing that John Keenan does. He likes the puck outs to take their time. 1 point apiece, 5.5 minutes gone in Croke Park. Limerick, the All-Ireland champions, up against Kilkenny. Out towards Barry Nash, has to turn inside his man. Full hardcore, full core press from Kilkenny at the start of this match. Ball down the far side, picked up there by Conor Fogarty. And Kilkenny moving the ball through the lines nicely. In towards William O'Donoghue, goes in, throws in the shoulder, wins the ball back as well. Looks like he's fouled when he got it as well, and there's the fist bump. Well, there's a microcosm of what William O'Donoghue was all about. Went in, got a ball he had no right to win, and subsequently wins a free for Limerick.
Yeah, Kilkenny just doing what Kilkenny done great in the noughties and trying to bring it in. They went intensity with intensity. Obviously William O'Donoghue went in, and Tom Phelan was trying to be a bit fancy with the ball. It was a fair shoulder to shoulder, but Adrian Mullen came in to try and match intensity, but he shouldered him into the chest. Free in for Limerick, another great psychological boost for Limerick. Just unbelievable that I suppose TJ Reid and Owen Cody both in quick succession took a shot when there was probably a better pass on. And if Kilkenny go with trying to win the game as individuals today, they're not going to win the game. They need to play like a team. So it's just interesting, two wides in a row in that nature.
Dermot Burns with the free from the middle of the field and over the bar, of course. So 6 minutes gone, nearly seven. Limerick 2 points to one in front. Dermot Burns with a free.
Yeah, and a great score. The wind has died down there, going by the two flags now. It definitely died down a bit, but a great score. Dermot Burns hits him straight as a die. Look, one of the best, if not the best, long range free take ever.
Puck out, batted down in front of himself by William O'Donoghue. Gets it in towards David Reedy. Five Kilkenny men around him, manages to step past the first one, can't go any further. Has to blindly puck it back towards Kyle Hayes, but it's dispossessed and won by Mullen in the midfield. Turning around, Adrian Mullen with the red helmet and the pink boots, delivers it long in towards the edge of the square. Beaten inside is Mike Casey. Ball bounces back, good for Mike Casey, into his hand thankfully, and out to another man with the red helmet. This time it's Nash for Limerick, and inside Tom Morrissey makes himself available to Kyle Hayes. They have to work through the lines to get the ball out. Darragh O'Donovan pulled and dragged and gets the free from TJ Reid, and it just goes to show Kilkenny looking to work it out once, James, and then in long and then full court press from there.
Yeah, we were saying Limerick were looking a little bit dodgy there in the first 5 minutes, but they've definitely settled in now. We're going into the 8 minute. They're after getting 2 points since we said it. Darren Burns is taking the wind has definitely picked up again, so it's he's between the 45-65 and the Hogan Stand sideline here. Going to be a tough free, but we're on about the matchup between TJ Reid, who's kind of gone out. The half hour line, he's kind of gone out into the middle of the field. But William Dunham is definitely after settling in there at centre back. He's looking very calm there.
Very weird game too, James, in that we haven't seen Peter Casey or Shamey Flanagan or get their hands at Garrod Hegarty. Haven't touched the ball. We're 8 minutes in.
Yeah, and just see Dermot taking the free here.
The wind is blowing that one away to the right hand side.
It's a very strange game so far in terms of the wind, because that it's hard for Dermot Burns to judge. And I think Seamus Flanagan and Peter Casey actually do a job for the team. We're on about Aaron Glenn being totally exposed inside. Aaron Glenn had three or four balls hit into him quick. There hasn't been many balls, only 8 minutes gone. So anyone in the full forward line, and Seamus Flanagan and Peter Casey are testament that there. You have to have unbelievable patience inside that.
Yeah, wind again blowing the ball down towards Mike Casey. Not one cleanly, but one by Tom Morrissey. Back in the edge of his own D, gives it to Mike Casey, looking around for the hand pass, can't get it off towards Kyle Hayes. Half dispossessed, Kyle Hayes goes in, puts the boot in. In goes Dan Morrissey, away out the field. First kind of ruck of the afternoon. In goes the hurley of Darragh Donovan now out towards Tom. He's lost his hurley out towards Cian Lynch. He manages to get it around. Look at the amount of Kilkenny jerseys around as Cian Lynch picks out a brilliant pass towards Peter Casey. Has to bounce it on the hurley. Steps all over the place. Back out towards David Reedy. Some score goes over the bar from David Reedy. It's Nallis gone to the right hand wide. Second wide of the afternoon. But the amount of work Limerick have to do, James Ryan, to get a shot at goal. Incredible intensity. 9 minutes gone. 2 points to one in front still.
Yeah, we often will. I use the word silky. They're looking very silky at the moment. Every ball is crisp, it's going to hand. Keane had a load of Kilkenny lads in around him. Just a quick pass off.
Chance now for Kilkenny. Ball bounces on the edge of the 21. Shot towards goal and back of the net from Peter
Owen Cody.
Owen Cody, the captain. Kilkenny always worth the goal. And it's 1-1 to 2 points, and the breaking ball inside went Kilkenny's way, and it's Cody's goal.
Yeah, look, and Kilkenny are playing very direct. I suppose they're known for it. They do play the odd passing, and they're playing very direct. They're trying to definitely target on Cody if he went in Dubai in the first 10 minutes. Mike Casey's come out one or two balls on Cody. He was unlucky, but you don't want that man getting the ball in front of goal. And look, it has to be said, even though Limerick are looking slick, Kilkenny's work rate, if they can keep this going for 70 minutes, we're in trouble. Every time Limerick fella has the ball, there's two, three, four fellas around him, and Limerick are getting the ball off quick, but it's a very interesting the way the game is going out so far.
Paddy Deegan, the one that gets the ball away here. Another chance to Kilkenny. Shot a goal from the far side of the field. And another point is Tom Phelan this time. Tom Phelan makes it 1-2 to 2 points. And quickly the game getting away from Limerick here.
Yeah, and it's one important thing that both teams are very good at, and that's why Kilkenny are Limerick champions, Limerick are Munster champions. Is it's all well and good getting a goal, but they're well able to tag on a couple of scores after when the team, a goal can kill your energy and kill that, and the other team can get great benefit out of them. Kilkenny are after doing that there in that instance.
Peter Casey held up on the far side, illegally so, says the referee, much to the annoyance of the Kilkenny fans. So 1-2 now to 2 points to score here after 11 minutes of the All-Ireland final in Croke Park.
Yeah, and a tough enough free now, it has to be said, for Aaron Gillane. He's actually just between the 45 and 65, but right on the Cusick stand sideline nearly. And the reason why, usually it's bread and butter stuff for any intercounty free taker, but there's definitely a kind of a swirling wind. It's hard to judge. It's kind of coming and going. So, look, you'd expect him to get it. Something similar for Dermot Burns, but it's at a difficult enough angle.
Margaret O'Brien has been in contact with us all the way from Como in Italy, listening in, originally from Friarstown. She's as far as a Limerick. And also on 086-123-9595. Yep. A message in from Australia from Teresa Griffith. 11 minutes and 39 seconds on. Aaron Gillane knocks over a score which makes it 1-2-3 in Kilkenny's favour.
Yeah, and as I've been saying already, if the scoreline was something similar at half time, you're only going in 2 or 3 down, Limerick will be very happy, because even though the wind has died down there for maybe a minute or two, it is very strong when it does come out down in Kilkenny's favour in this half.
Yeah, certainly does. Mike Casey out in front this time, gets it towards Kyle Hayes, towards Barry Nash, way out the field, Barry Nash. Tom Morrissey gets the shoulder, takes it, hand pass it out towards Walter Walsh, and he's beaten to it, and Limerick under severe pressure every time they get the ball. They're turned over again. Martin Keown has in towards Mullen. Keane Lynch goes in with Tom Morrissey, but Mullen spins away. Kilkenny moving. Oh, William O'Donoghue is going into the book after that, let me tell you. It goes towards Tom Phelan. Phelan puts the ball over the bar. His second score today, and William O'Donoghue is going to get booked for a late tackle.
Yes, I mind about Limerick being silky. That was some layoff from Adrian Mullen there. But again, Tom Morrissey got a pass off Barry Nash. Barry Nash done his overlap. You often see it as a winger in soccer or something. But Walter Welch had it right. Barry Nash done well to intercept the ball again. Dinny laid it off again, and Martin Keown came in and intercepted it. So Kilkenny's work rate is immense at the moment, and they're getting a lot of joy out of it there. That was a score that was got out of pure heart and determination out of Kilkenny, and it brings it to 1-3 to 3 points to Kilkenny at the moment.
1-3 to 3 points is right. Seamus Flanagan, look at the way Kilkenny are moving around midfield. Kyle Hayes back down again. How is there so many Kilkenny men around? William James figured that one out. It's into the hands of Owen Cody, spinning away, managed to beat two men, gets the shot off again, the hand pass out the far side, and that's going to be a wide to the right hand side. Kilkenny's third wide of the afternoon, that one from Phelan. He's getting on the whirl of ball there in front of Dermot Burns. We know Limerick's half back line don't mark anyone, but 30 minutes in, Kilkenny in front by 3.
Yeah, I'm Kilkenny are probably playing one or two inside, but it's just pure heart and determination. They're getting so many men around the ball. Their half forward line is definitely pushing back as well. Nicky went long there, and Tom Phelan actually went up for the ball with Richie Reid. So that'll tell you a wing forward going up with a centre back for the ball. So it'll tell you that they're reading the long puck out and going back. But Kilkenny are just kind of going man for man with maybe one man back, but they're just working. Can they keep it going for 70 minutes? It's going to be very interesting how Derek Ling uses the bench here if we're going to use that kind of energy.
Well, it's almost like a defensive line in rugby, James. Every time a Limerick halfback gets the ball from the puck out, there's five Kilkenny men in a line blocking that ball through. brilliant homework done from them. But the big question is, and it always has been all year, can you keep this intensity up against Limerick?
Well, the, and the other interesting thing, while we see Dermot Burns there, I think he's staying inside, they're actually changing it rotationally as well. You look at TJ Reid, he's usually out in the middle field. Now he's taking a break inside in Barry Nash for 5-10 minutes. So coming, the way they can come in and around and change it up is a good help. Well, Cody's gone out into the half-hard line as we see another sideline being taken, just to give the boys a bit of a breather. But no, you cannot keep that intensity going for 70 minutes, but you can if you freshen it up and bring on subs at the right time. So I think the sub bench is going to be very interesting as this game plays out in the second half.
Sideline cut, gone in towards Tom Mercy, kind of strolled over towards it, didn't get it. William O'Donoghue in the book, on towards Dermot Burns, hurler of the year, gives it towards former hurler of the year and Partickswell clubmate Keane Linson. Now Dermot Burns is in trouble here as well. He's going to go into the book, no doubt. Kilkenny man laid out on the ground, and the referee is going to see this as an act of intention by Dermot Burns. Dermot Burns has came in, it wasn't, but it's all, the referee is the one that matters here. And it's going to be a yellow card minimum, I think.
Yeah, I know. I'll just see it there. I would just see the replay there. There wasn't really much in it, to be fair. And that's not even being biased, being with a Limerick jersey on, because it actually looked worse than was, because he went in with his hurley hand, but he's running, he's followed through, kind of hit him. It'd actually be a harsh enough yellow card, probably will be. But the reason even you see tackles like that start going on is Kilkenny are winning a tactical battle here at the moment. It'd be great if we were just going up to half time, or Limerick could go in and change it up a bit, because all this shot passing, they're actually, it's strange. Usually when a team cuts out all the shot passing and all that, they've got Limerick are struggling to get a quick puck out off short, and when they go long, Kilkenny seem to have more numbers around the ball, and all the short passing around the middle of the field, Kilkenny are able to get tackles in. So this is actually playing out very, very similar to 2019. I hate to make comparison to the game we lost and came back, but Kilkenny are managing it, the hurley in, the hand in, they're working with great intensity. But again, on a positive from a Limerick point of view, there's only 16 minutes gone, it's 1-3 to 3 points in Kilkenny's favour, and if they go in even 4 or 5 points down at half time, so Kilkenny, even though with all their dominance and tactical awareness going well for them at the moment, still only 3 points in it.
Yeah, Owen Murphy to take the resultant free, and looks like he's got the distance as well. Has he got the score? He has, and over the bar it goes, his first point of the championship. 32 years of age, a super save in the semi-final, and it's now 1-4 to 3 points to Kilkenny's favour.
And that is going to be a very worrying factor for Kilkenny in the second half. If they give away frees like that, Dermot Burns will pop them over all day. But the win definitely assisted on Murphy there. It was an unbelievable score. And you can't be giving frees away from the 45. Imagine the defensive 45 up, or Kilkenny will score them in this half.
Puck out goes to Kyle Hayes, in towards William O'Donoghue, then Mike Casey, down into the corner. The first proper ball down towards Seamus Flanagan. Can't get it into the hand. Can't get it into the hand the second time or the third time. Looked like he was pushing the back. And there's the 50-50 ball, and the ball kicked out over the sideline. And a sideline ball to Kilkenny in another battle won for the men in black and amber.
So you could see it there straight away. Tommy Welch's job wasn't to win the ball there, it was to spoil the ball. Spoil the ball. I remember Clare the tactic a couple of years ago. He spoiled that ball. He knew there was going to be support coming. Tom Phelan came in straight away and won a sideline ball.
Phelan for Kilkenny delivers a diagonal ball. They worked it out of the corner easy. Kyle Hayes waiting for the ball, beaten to it. Limerick a little bit off at the moment. Back inside towards Walter Walsh. Walter Walsh with the shot at goal. Walter Walsh to the right and wide. Kilkenny's fourth wide of the first half. Will they rue those chances later? Limerick off the boil at the moment. Darragh O'Donovan can't get it out. Has to turn around three times. Gets it towards Barry Nash. Better from Limerick as they work it in short towards Keane Lynch. But he's surrounded now by five Kilkenny men. One of them pulling out of his hurley. And the referee says it's a free, to which Keane Lynch puts the ball down.
Yeah, but a very, very lucky there. Limerick were very lucky. That was actually the wrong pass, but it was given to the right man, if that makes sense, because he showed unbelievable hands there. He's after winning the free. It was actually, you have to give credit to John Donnelly, the pressure he put on. It was just a fantastic pair of hands that won that free. So Limerick are given the ball, but it's not usually that man has plenty of time in the ball, or a second or two. Kilkenny are giving him no time in the ball. But again, look, it results in a free for Dermot Burns straight in front of goal on his defensive 65, with a wind or without a wind or against the wind. He's sure to put this over, given the fact that it's straight in the middle of the goal as well. He can give that ball the extra power that it needs. So I'm putting this down as a score, hopefully.
Okay, well, Limerick with only 1 point from play so far, and Dermot Burns knocks over his second of the afternoon. His second from referee stops the rock for now. 1-4 to 4 points, and we are 18 and a half minutes into this Lawler in final coverage as always on Live 95, brought to you by Limerick Motor Centre, your main handed dealer on the Ballysimon Road. Up into the air goes Walter Walsh, beaten to it by Kyle Hayes. Didn't get it the first time, gets it the second time. Surely a free, referee says no. Away goes Tom Morrissey with the diesel engine onto the bomber Kyle Hayes. Brilliant angle of balling towards Aaron Gallant. He has it in his hand. Gallant spins around his man and over the shoulder. And now Limerick are beginning to hurl 19 minutes into it, 1-4-5. Beautiful hurling for Limerick.
Yeah, and there was a goal chance there. I don't think we give Aaron Gallant enough credit about his agility. He took a turn there. Hugh Lawler, he salted him actually. He could have went for goal there, but I think he made the right decision to tip the ball over the bar. But Kilkenny doing a lot of movement in their half forward line. They're actually creating an overlap, which we're seeing the whole time here. So if Limerick don't win the ball clean, usually Kilkenny will win the breaking ball because there's so many numbers there.
Keane Lynch has it in his hand on the far side, back towards Garrod Hegarty. Spins around his mat, pulled and dragged by the second one. Has it in his hand, he's getting no free, seems to keep going. Referee, he's now heading back towards his own 21. In goes TJ Reid, falls on the ball. Walter Walsh over there as well. Still Garrod Hegarty. Oh, he's on his knees. Gives it away towards Keane Lynch. He's spun around. And the old sign of a free. There you go. 5 or 6 minutes after it, the first one should have been given.
Hegarty was fouled there, but Keane Lynch is well able to turn and make it look like a blatant pull, so the ref has no choice. So Keane Lynch is having a great start to this match. 20 minutes in, he's after a lot of possessions, and he's definitely taking the pressure off Limerick at the moment.
Dermot Burns with a free deep inside his own territory, away over on the far side underneath the Cusick stand. Delivers this one long, wind holding it up down towards David Reedy and Tom Morrissey. The hurley of the arm man goes out and beats it down, but it's Kilkenny that come away with it on the charge and turned over once more. Tom Morrissey gets it off towards Gallan underneath the Hogan stand. From Gallan it's away to the left hand side though, and wide from our side as the umpire puts the hands up fairly quick, and that is Limerick's third wide of the afternoon. Kilkenny with four so far. Sharp puck out taken down the far side. Kilkenny trying to clear it out here, working back towards his own goal. It's John Donnelly, gives it in towards centre half back Richie Reid, delivers it long. Kyle Hayes can put up the paw, he can't, gets it, turns away from his man, can't get the hand free at the moment. In towards Barry Nash. Nash looking for Keane Lynch, can't find him, has to turn around, goes back towards Dermot Burns twists the entire body around and delivers it into the corner. Surely there's a free inside there. How did Aaron Gallan end up on the ground? Referee says there's no free, and away come Kilkenny clearing the ball away from their own line. Seamus Flanagan putting the pressure on, bouncing the ball inside there. Here's Mikey Butler. Butler has to turn it around towards Tommy Walsh and in towards the waiting Mikey Butler once more. He put up the hand, picked away by Seamus Flanagan. There's a big momentum swing coming here. Whoever wins this possession, there's going to be a roar from the crowd. Player slipping around, Garrod Hegarty has it, turns away from midfield. There's an overrun from Barry Nash. Can he pick him out? Up over the far side, and he can. Nash has to race for it though. He's in a race, a foot race on the far side with Owen Cody. Nash picks it up. What's he going to do? Is he going to go for a score from here? He's not. He's going to deliver it in towards the edge of the square. In goes Gallan, the hand, the hurley, everything pulled and dragged. One-handed pull from Gallan and away to the right-hand side and wide. And I tell you one thing, Limerick now, as John Kiley says, are now becoming physically responsible. 21 minutes gone, James, is 1-4-5.
Yeah, they're definitely after raising the intensity and matching Kilkenny, if not even bettering them. Kilkenny tried to solo out from defence twice now, their last two times trying to solo defence. Limerick have dispossessed them. It's great to see if Limerick can keep that work rate going up to half time. It's going to be brilliant. You can visibly see it there. But again, look, it's really a war of attrition out there at the moment, even giving the score 1-4-5 points.
Oh, TJ Reid catches an absolute beauty from the puck out from Murphy. Now he's standing there. The referee's giving a free. Soft enough free, but TJ Reid deserved it for the take. Going back towards his own goal. And it would be TJ Reid's first score of the All-Ireland final. Who would have had that at 22 minutes and 30 seconds?
It's a very hard thing to do, but I think you nearly just need to spoil TJ Reid. I don't think you go up with the ball for him at all. Hugh Lawler's doing the very same thing. Now, Aaron Glenn nearly caught the ball, but if he's any bit off at all, Hugh Lawler's just trying to spoil him. He's not trying to catch. You have to do the same with TJ Reid, because more often than not, if you win that ball, it was a soft free, there's no doubt about it, but if you win the ball in the air and you go down, the ref is going to give it to you. It's nearly a free for having brilliance at catching the high ball is what you get.
266 on the scoreboard this season for TJ Reid, and over the bar it goes. Make that 267. It's now Kilkenny 1-5, Limerick 5 points.
Yeah, and I have to say about TJ Reid, Don, as we watch him, is definitely one of his last years, not his last. He has to go down as one of the greatest hurlers of all time.
Speaking of which, here comes Kyle Hayes, bouncing his way towards the left-hand side, shortens the grip in front of Peter Casey, couldn't get it the first time. Oh, referee is given a free from where Kyle Hayes was, maybe. Well, if it was a free, it's from where the ball ended. And the referee says no, back it goes. Garrod Hegarty's his hand up, and here comes Aaron Galan. Well, James Ryan, you're paid the big bucks. You tell me what that's for.
Pull out a jersey there, because I've just, after seeing the replay there, I'm delighted it just came up in front of me there. Yeah, I didn't see it. The referee actually didn't see it either. I think the linesman, which is great, because that's what they're there for, brought it to his attention. Now the free is over where the linesman is, but yeah, it's good to see John Kyle now giving a couple of lads down the sideline just a little few words of.
You've not heard this theory, no?
What's this?
The theory that Carroll Hegarty comes over to John Kiley after 21 minutes in every match and gets an instruction.
Right, okay.
Yeah, there
well,
you go.
Well, the
24
team,
minutes in, he came over for a chat.
The team just needs a certain little twinge or change or something, because Kilkenny are actually very smart with their puck outs, and their work rate is very good. And even there, they didn't win the free, which is gone. Oh,
hits the upright and bounces out. Everyone stood there. Looked like it was going wide from well out. Aaron Galan. Oh, that's a free out. Seamus Flanagan pulling down Owen Murphy. That's fair enough. But Aaron Galan had judged the wind almost to perfection because it hit the post.
But what Kilkenny are doing very well is Mikey Butler, even there with the ball that went in that we didn't realise it was a free that Aaron Galan just took. He's very good at just stifling, again spoiling. Peter Casey up, just spoiled it away, knocked it away and getting in. So, look, there's battles all over the field. It's very interesting at the moment. 1-5 to 5 points, only 3 points in and 25 minutes gone.
John Donnelly makes a run diagonally across looking for possession. TJ Reid, the target. Up goes William O'Donoghue. Came through four men together, but it breaks on the far side. Martin Keown on the 21-yard line for Kilkenny. Hand pass the side towards Reid. Reid half stop by Keane Lynch. Puts in the hurley, then kicks it away by Kyle Hayes. What an interception that was by Keane Lynch. And Limerick forcing Kilkenny away from goal. Cody spinning, bouncing the ball, still being put under pressure. Oh, brilliant catch by him. In goes Barry Nash and flicks the slitter away. Referee says no free. Yes, he's still in there. Ah, stop. That's not a free. Whatever about the first one, the second one hasn't. 1-5 to 5 points. Kilkenny with another chance here to go even further in front. 25 minutes gone. Brilliant skill by Owen Cody, it must be said. Yeah. And eventually stopped.
Well, TJ Reid is probably playing hurling on the panel since 2006, maybe 2007. And I'd say 95% of the time when he gets a ball like that, it's a goal. So Limerick done very well to intercept it. Kyle Hayes had no real option but to kick it out. He kicked it out so he'd get the ball. But this is the difference between Kilkenny and other teams. When he kicked that out there, he needs to kick that ball out the sides, because there's players hovering. There's black and amber jerseys all over the place hovering around. Owen Cody's after three or four times now, cutting in across Kyle Hayes' shoulder. And that's what makes them different. They work that a little bit harder. TJ Reid knocks the ball over. It's a handy free. So it ends up being 1-6 to 5 points. But again, Limerick done well there to cut out the goal chance. And again, that's probably where we're missing Declan Hannan there. Declan Hannan would never went up for that ball there. William Dunn nearly pushed Darren Burns into the ball. One man has to go for the ball all the time.
Far out the far side. Shot at goal for Kilkenny. And over the bar it goes from Richie Reid. Richie Reid's first score of the afternoon. 3 in a row now for Kilkenny. 1-7 to 5 points their lead. Double scores.
Yeah, I saw a very interesting stat there on the telly. They were inside before we came out for the match there about an hour ago, where Limerick had 55% from puckouts last year. Kilkenny only 45. Kilkenny won more clean possession, but Limerick dominated. This first half, Kilkenny have dominated on Nicky's long puckout. There's no doubt about it.
Yeah, Kilkenny winning another one. And it's Richie Reid once more, the centre half back. Kilkenny hurling as well as they would have hoped. Barry Nash with TJ Reid. Nash gets it, has time to bend down and pick up the hurley and get the ball, and now he's running in down a cul-de-sac. He's surrounded and he's turned over.
to be fair, he was going down the wrong alley there. He done unbelievably well against TJ Reid there. He actually out-muscled him and everything out. Done fair well, but again, that's the pressure Kilkenny put on you. I know I'm complimenting them all the time about their work rate, but Barry Nash should have looped around. But they put the pressure on you, as he would have looped around there against any other team in Munster. But he knows the two or three fellas behind him, if he did, to tackle him. They weren't there in that instance, but he knows more often than not there is. So look, Kilkenny again are after upping the work rate we're complimenting Limerick about. They're kind of after going out of the game a small bit. It's double scoring at the moment, 1-7 to 5 points. We see TJ Reid with the wind between the 45-65 between the goals, definitely going to put it over. So they're gone 11 points to 5 up.
Yeah, with 4 in a row for Kilkenny. Limerick need to stop this momentum before half time, and all the wind is there. They will be in serious trouble as TJ Reid knocks that one over. So his third free of the afternoon makes it 1-8 now, which is 11 points to 5. 27 got.
And again, we see that TJ Reid's gone back out to centre forward. Walter Welch gone into the corner. It's interesting enough, Dan Morrissey, every time Walter Welch gone in, he's over in the corner as well. As we see a Limerick fella down, trying to break the rod. Obviously, they've changed the purse. It's not Nicky anymore. John Keegan's having none of it. He's saying play on.
Yeah, it's Tom Morrissey. Garrod Hegarty back there. 7 Kilkenny men around the ball. There's a ruck around the edge of the 40. Kilkenny trying to go in there. Keane Lynch can't get it. Tries to get it. Puts in the hurley. He's in there with TJ Reid. Still on the ground. Garrow with the boot in. And Kilkenny look way hungry for the ball. Away comes Richie Reid. Kilkenny. Black and amber. Flowing. Out in front. Foul on Mike Casey. By Owen Cody. And if it wasn't a foul, let me tell you, it was a nailed on goal. And Limerick are living dangerously here. Trailing by 6 points. 7 minutes to go to half time. And John Coyley and Paul Kinnock now out in the middle of the field trying to give instructions. And Mike Casey, lucky there that the referee decided it was free.
I'm just seeing that I would hate to be a referee on All-Ireland Final Day because we get the advantage of the replay here. But Owen Cody was gone so far away from Mike Casey there, you could see why the ref didn't give it. Now, I do think he tripped him. Mike Casey could have tripped his own ankles there. Owen Cody was given out a lot after the free, so maybe Mike Casey tripped himself with his own ankles there. It results in a free out for Limerick. Thank God, because there's a lot of space there. But again, it's worrying me what you said there. Kilkenny are looking to hungry or winning all that breaking ball or dirty ball.
Yeah, again, ball inside towards the edge of the square, and Kilkenny have won it. It's on the deck once more, though. In goes Garrod Hegarty, making a nuisance of himself. On the 21-yard line, bodies everywhere. Referee blows the whistle, says he's going to throw it in. Every 50-50 ball in this game so far, James, has gone the way of Kilkenny.
Yeah.
Six in front. Limerick only 5 points, James, scored. They scored 131 in last year's All-Ireland Final. 5 points coming up towards half-time.
Yeah, there is a strong wind there now on a positive. That's the one thing I can say. But they've been completely bare that period of about 5 minutes. We said Limerick up the work rate. They've been outworked at the moment, and that's why there's only 5 points. They're defensively very good, Kilkenny. And every time Limerick man has a ball, they're being intercepted, and there's no time in the ball.
Yeah, Peter Casey turned over there on the 21-yard line. Blocks down the ball, but again, it blocks down and goes into Kilkenny man's hand. Then onto the ground. Then Tom Morrissey can't pick it up. Neither can Kyle Hayes. Limerick being beaten to absolutely everything, and away comes Mikey Butler with the ball. Now into our Seamus Flanagan, he can't pick it up. Gives it towards Keane Lynch. Is the referee giving a free in? Keane Lynch nearly lost a shin, and the referee says it's a free in to Limerick. Luckily enough for Limerick, they're going to get a score here. But
Mikey Butler is after pulling late, and I don't think he even heard the whistle, but he just pulled high as well. If they showed a replay, straight across Keane Lynch's leg, he's hobbling. I'm surprised Mikey Butler didn't break a hurley off him. But the players weren't happy. Results in a free-in for Limerick, but it was a fair swipe, definitely a yellow card. But John Keegan again didn't see it.
Limerick haven't scored in 12 minutes in this All-Ireland semi-final, or All-Ireland final, I should say, first half. So
and again, there's no sweepers, there's no extra defenders, there's no anything. I know Kilkenny's half-forward line are playing a bit deep, but it's basically man-on-man stuff. And Limerick are an amazing team because they're only Aaron Glenn's going to put this ball over the bar to make it 1-8 to 6 points. They're by no means out of the game, but when in terms of possessions, in terms of turnovers and all that, Kilkenny are wiping them, but it's still 11 points to 6 with 32 minutes gone.
Yeah, Aaron Glenn, his third point of the afternoon, his second from a free. Dermot Burns with 2 from free. Limerick with only 2 scores in play. 32 minutes nearly gone in this final. David Reedy gone in, almost wing back at this stage, picked up by Mike Casey. Again, 4 Kilkenny men around him, but he manages to get the ball clear towards Darragh Donovan and towards Kyle Hayes. Now Garrod Hegarty down in front of Aaron Gallan. It's when it works, it works. Here comes Gallan, can't pick it up the first time. He's got Kyle Hayes off his shoulder, gives it right towards Keane Lynch. Keane Lynch over the bar for Limerick. Keane Lynch over the bar, and it's 1-8 to 7. 2 in a row for Limerick, and they hadn't scored in 13 minutes. Better from them. Gap is 4.
Yeah, a lot better from him. And look, even when Limerick are going poor, you have to compliment the ball to get into Aaron Glenn. I think Aaron Glenn looks like definitely the fastest, deceptively fast person I've ever seen in my life. Hugh Lawler isn't slow, and he's out in front. Hugh Lawler is very nervous of him. Aaron Glenn is showing his feet there again. Unbelievable. And again, you go back to Owen Cody and TJ Reid's wide in the first half. Glenn could have took the shot there, would have been hooked or blocked. He gave the ball off to Keane Lynch.
Long ball over the top from Kilkenny from the puck out into the hand of Martin Keown. Off the post, it goes into the hands of Owen Cody on the 14-yard line. Cody steps up to Emmer Burns, shot towards goal. Bounces it on the ground and wide of the left-hand post to Nicky Quaid. What a big moment that would have been in the game.
Yep.
5 wides for Kilkenny, and again the long ball from the puck out, causing Limerick awful trouble. They're 4 behind with 3 minutes to go to half time.
Yeah, Nicky's even given out. The Dermot Burns totally switched off their hands and the hips. They don't know what's going on. He can't get the quick puck out. But that's the difference between Kilkenny and other teams as well, Dan. He could have tipped that ball over the bar, no problem. He went for goal.
Puck, they go for a juggler the whole Lynch. Thing. Beaten to it again. Kilkenny picking up the scrappy ball. In goes Peter Casey. Half beaten to it. In goes Tom Morrissey's hurley. Gets it in towards Keane Lynch. Keane Lynch spinning away. Hand on his back by Richie Reid. Gets the hand pass off here towards David Reedy. Reedy strikes the ball and over the bar from David Reedy. 188 points, and Limerick begin to come alive as the first half comes to an end.
Yeah, Limerick coming alive again. Great team play. Keane Lynch could have went, took the shot again. Drew the man, laid it off. But again, Kilkenny will be very disappointed there. I see Dermaline talking to a couple of his management. It's down to Kilkenny's missed errors there of not clearing the ball, getting the ball into their hand. Yeah, Limerick are putting a bit of pressure on, but it's down to little mistakes from them. But again, you don't make mistakes in Limerick, they'll punish you.
Long ball down on top of Walter Walsh, beaten away inside towards Cody. Cody picks it up, spins one way, spins another, gets it into the hand, can't get the hand away, tries to get it towards Mullen. Reedy goes in, tries to pour in the shoulder, does. Mullen ends up on the ground, he's running around the place, he's taking plenty of steps. Ball breaks away towards Limerick, and it's Peter Casey and towards Tom Morrissey. Oh, Tom Morrissey half blocked down as he went towards midfield, puts in the Hurley and gives away the free. And it's 188 points with a minute to go at the half time, but Limerick needed that one. They needed to come away with the ball. Points behind, 60 seconds to go towards injury time.
I think John Keegan's done a good job of the game, but in that instance there, he gave a soft free. But in fairness, if he gave Adrian Mullins one inside in the D, you would have justified a lot more than the one he gave. It was more of a Conor Fogarty just fell over going over the ball. But look, it results in a free for TJ Reid. He had a free in the exact same position, just on the outside of the goal there to put it over. So again, that's a killer of a free from Limerick point of view, because they've done all the great work, all the momentum. Crowd got behind them, but again, this kills Limerick's momentum. 11 points to 8, it's looking like it's going to be 12, and it gets Kilkenny back on the scoreboard, back putting the ball over the bar.
TJ Reid drills this one. Nicky Quaid says it's wide, and it is wide. 6 wides and a huge let off for Limerick towards Kyle Hayes. Thinks it down in front of him towards Keane Lynch. Lynch with the Hurley in, can't get it away, blocked back there by Richie Reid. Reid fouled by Garrod Hegarty, and it's lazy from Garrod. And the man from St. Patrick's, who struggled for form all year, has not made any impression in this opening half, and you can see the frustration on his face there with 2 minutes of additional time.
Yeah, I was just about to say to you there, even though the game is 188, it's been low scoring, but it's been an unbelievable war of attrition tactical game, and there has been very few, well, in my opinion, unforced frees or ridiculous frees, bar that one there where there was nearly no need to do it. So it's been an unbelievable game so far in terms of work rate, desire, hunger, all them things.
TJ Reid with the free, and over the bar it goes. So his fourth. It's now 1-9 to 8 points.
Yeah, and again, a harder free for TJ Reid there, it has to be said. It was further out at a different angle, so very strange for him to hit the last wide, uncharacteristic, and I don't think the man has ever had 2 in a row wide, so we could have marked that one off.
Nicky Quay with the puck out into the wind, down the far side on top of Garrod Hegarty and Tom Morrissey. Hegarty plucks it out of the sky, better from him. There's a short little ball if he wants to play it towards Damon Burns. He's beaten two at that. He went on the overlap, couldn't get it, gets the Hurley in. Kilkenny man asks. Dap. Referee gives a free out to Kilkenny. Soft free.
And I think that just sums up Limerick at the moment. It was just a mistouch from Dermot Burns. Again, Tom Phelan done very well to get back the field and intercept the ball, but and then just a big push over. So, look, again, half-time can't come quick enough here, because, again, we're hoping for this unbelievable third quarter that Limerick always come out with. I think they're going to have to do something tactically. Hopefully they move back their half-back line and get the puck out sorted, and hopefully it'll be a better half, second half.
A long, long ball again down towards Barry Nash into the hands of Tom Morrissey, and through the line comes Kyle Hayes. No free given as Kyle Hayes gets it in towards Keane Lynch. He's been pulled and dragged, no free there either. Keane Lynch still motoring, can't find his man, pops it up over the top towards Tom Morrissey, normally accurate from way out the field. Morrissey, and over the bar it goes, and it's 1-9 to 9, and that was classic Limerick.
Yeah, and I'll tell you one thing, Don, we were missing Keane Lynch for last year's All-Ireland final, but well, fair lucky boys is not missing this year. I'm going to say he's definitely Limerick's man in the match at the moment. 2 points as we see half time is coming. Big roar out of both teams. He's 2 points from play. He's got 4 or 5 assists. The man has been awesome.
Half time in Croke Park. It is Limerick 9 points, Kilkenny 1-9. Well, James Ryan, who had that scoreline at half time following on from what happened last year? Chances converted from play, 5 apiece, 6 wides to Kilkenny, 4 to Limerick. And the scoring chances, look at the amount of turnovers, 22 turnovers won by Kilkenny, 18 by Limerick. Incredible stuff in that first half. As tight as we expected it to be, a puck of a ball between them, James, sum it up.
Yeah, I said it, I think I said it 5 minutes into the game, where it was 1 point to Kilkenny and no point to Limerick, that we said at half time, if they're only going to be 3-4 points down, that we'd be very happy. Again, I suppose if you look at the game, the way the game is going, and if the second half takes the same nature, 1-9 to 9, Limerick only got 9 points and they're 3 points behind. It's a massive lead, but I think this game is going to open up in the last 20 minutes. Most games do. The big question you asked halfway during the first half, can Limerick, can Limerick stay playing as poor as they were there after upping it a bit, and Kilkenny keep that work rate going that did in the first half? Well, that's going to be the big question. I don't think any team can keep that intensity up for that long unless they make four or five subs in quick succession, maybe in the between the 40 and 50th minute. But at the moment, the game's in the melting pot. Limerick are by no means out of it, but Kilkenny have definitely won that game first half in terms of breaking ball, in terms of possessions, in terms of maybe shooting chances or goal chances. Kilkenny scored a goal and they obviously had one other goal chance. You could count TJ Reid's one there as a goal chance, only he dropped the ball. Maybe there was cover back there. So Kilkenny have definitely troubled us in the forwards a bit more. So it's going to be very interesting. Limerick are going to come out, we always know, tactically and tactical awareness from the management and the players. They've got hurling intelligence. They know they're going to set up maybe a bit different. But it's going to be very interesting to see what Kilkenny do against the wind. Can they pull a rabbit out of the hat? Can they do something different? Are they going to be able to feed more ball into their full forward line? Again, we always say win wins again for no one. If Kilkenny gets smart and play a few balls in front of O'Cody, I certainly don't want to see that, do you?
No, certainly don't. 199 points to score at halftime. Kilkenny in front by three. Limerick, the three times All-Ireland champions in a row, 3 points behind. Questions have been asked already this season. Answers have been given. What's going to happen? Welcome back to Croke Park. It is All-Ireland Hurling Final Day. Limerick versus Kilkenny in the second half. Just underway here. And Donn O'Sullivan on commentary alongside me, James Ryan. 199 points. David Reedy in possession for Limerick, away over on the far side of the field. Gets it in towards Aaron Gallan. Puts down to Hurley. Bats it up. But only into the hand of a waiting Kilkenny defender. And that Kilkenny defender is actually John Donnelly wearing number 12. There's a change to Kilkenny at half time as well. Patrick Walsh wearing number 19 in. And James Ryan, we are going to see if this third quarter is really what Limerick are all about. Here's Garrod Hegarty on the ball in possession. Bit more time out towards Darragh O'Donovan. He delivers one down into the corner towards David Reedy. Reedy waiting for the ball, gets it into his hand. Reedy normally accurate. Hurley half blocked down though. And it's, as I said to Luke Liddy at half time here, every single 50-50 ball has broken into the hand of a Kilkenny man. And here is Patrick Walsh out this side towards Paddy Deegan for Kilkenny. 199 points, 1 minute of the second half gone already. Limerick with the win, no changes to them at half time. Up goes Barry Nash, half beaten to it. In goes Phelan now for Kilkenny. 2 points in play in the first half. Still Phelan going along towards the 21. Has a shot brought by Dermot Burns. Brilliant. Kilkenny going for the juggler already in there towards TJ Reid. Out comes Dan Morrissey towards Kyle Hayes. The Limerick crowd know how important the next 17 or so minutes are for Limerick. Long ball in from Kyle Hayes. Two Limerick men inside waiting for the ball. Beaten to it though by Tommy Walsh of Kilkenny. And out towards Patrick Walsh. Patrick Walsh turning his man. Hand pass in towards TJ Reid in midfield. Now Kilkenny have to work it through the lines on the air. Towards Walter Walsh. Walsh will have plenty of that wrist work to get this one over the bar. If he strikes it, it's gone to the left and wide. And the start of the second half, James Ryan, much like the first.
Yeah, it's. I think Limerick has started positive, okay, but Walter Welch should be very disappointed. Usually their shots, he always puts over. He two wides here in front of us. Well, one mishit and one wide as well. But again, yeah, but look, Aaron Glenn could have touched that ball. It was very difficult now. It was down his ankles. He was running full speed. It was a great ball across. But look, at least Limerick have got a couple of possessions and they're in the game at the moment in the second half.
Puck out from Nicky Quaid. Down towards Keane Lynch, wins it, gets it off towards Seamus Flanagan. Flanagan on the 21-yard line, and it is... Ooh. Oh, that's an awful miss. Oh.
Yeah, Seamus Flanagan's first wide there. Just a bit outside the D, bread and butter stuff. I don't know, is it a bit, what would you compare that to, a bit of tension, whatever, but still 199 points. Limerick after winning a free again. I was just about to say that score that Seamus Flanagan got, and hopefully he'll come here from Dermot Burns. Looks like he's going to take it fair. Just settle him in. What you want to do second half is just get a ball over the bar, get a point, and say, all right, lads, we're back in this with the win, the whole lot. So look, hopefully Dermot Burns can do it. It's good that it happened straight after Seamus Flanagan's wide, that Dermot Burns' ball put down there, just to ease that tension, ease that nerves, put the ball over the bar. He's on his own 65 with the wind, straight in front of goal again, as we said in the first half. Bread and butter stuff for him, but very, very uncharacteristic wide out chance flag. He's still kind of shaking the head inside there.
Yeah.
So I think that just sums up Limerick's day. They're doing great things, and then just a sudden psychological mind burst there out of nowhere and can kill momentum of it.
Coverage as always on Live 95, brought to you by Limerick Motor Centre, main Hyundai dealer in the Valley Simon Road. So we are 38 minutes in. Dermot Burns knocks over a free. And it's 1-9-10.
And I can't for the life of me, Don, explain the importance of a long-range free taker. If Clare had won, they would have won the final. If Clare had won the last day, who knows, they probably could have beaten Kilkenny. Vital, and to give Dermot Burns credit, it's very rare he misses under pressure or not, so great score to him.
Breaking ball again in towards Phelan for Kilkenny. Now the two Limerick men are around him, and the referee gives a free in, and Garrow Higgerty celebrates it like he's won the lotto, and it's a free to Limerick. Very important. Just to let you know, Tom, Teresa, Derek, Liz, Mike, and Margaret are all watching us from Coosadassy. We also have John McCluskey and John Brady from South Carolina in the USA. And make sure you text us in on 086-123-9595. Shout out also from Sydney, Australia, from Anna Sheehan and Brewery and Seamus Hartnett and Ahan, Limerick Aboo. They say we already had several messages already on WhatsApp from Aoife Griffin in Australia. And of course, we had Margaret O'Brien from Lake Como. So standing over this one, Tom Morrissey with the last score of the first half. Deirdre Burns with the first score of the second to make it 1-9 to 10 points in Kilkenny's favour. And it is Deirdre Burns standing over this one. About 3 metres inside his own half, just above the Imon 2023 wording on the pitch, and Jimmer Burns puts it over. 4-3 of the afternoon, second score in a row for Limerick, 1-9 to 11. The gap is 1.
Yeah, and the two biggest psychological roars of the game. Kilkenny roared when Barry Nash over took too many steps with the ball, and so did Limerick there. Oh my God, some score. Tom Phelan, straight from Owen Murphy's puck out. Tom Phelan catches the ball, puts it over the bar. And I was just about to say, Tom Phelan done very well, but overcarried the last ball. And what a response. And when you make a mistake, what a response to catch a high ball and put a shot over the bar.
Limerick make another mistake, and the ball is into the hand here of Martin Keown. And Martin Keown, luckily enough for Limerick, has put the ball wide. So another wide for Kilkenny, their sixth. And that's 40 minutes gone here. Kilkenny by 2.
That's a lot of wides done for Kilkenny. I think they went 32 minutes the last day nearly without a wide. So to have 6 there, and we're just gone into the second half, is a lot for them.
Free to Kilkenny from the puck out. Tom Morrissey and Keane Lynch and Seamus Flanagan went in for the ball, and the referee says that Pelly Deegan ended up on the ground. It has to be a free.
But that's the difference I'm saying about Tom Phelan. When Joe, you make a mistake to go up there, catch the ball, you're back on with a double positive, catching a high ball, putting over the bar. Seamus Flanagan now is on a double negative, and trust me, it's not like algebra and maths where that becomes a positive. He's just, head is down, he's getting a bit frustrated. It's not been his day so far. He's had one shot in goal and it's ended up being wide in front of goal. So we just hope he's a fella that we need maybe kicking into gear a bit. I said maybe Seamus Flanagan might get a little bit of an edge off Tommy Welch, but Tommy Welch is also the man he's marking, is having a good game also.
Yeah, 110 to 11. Pádraig Walsh wearing number 19 from Tullerone is on for Conor Fogarty at half time. Owen Murphy from Glenmore, the goalkeeper, gets it out here towards Richie Reid. Oh, plenty of space inside once again for Phelan. He is getting the freedom of Croke Park. Kyle Hayes can't stop and puts in the hurley. Eventually gets the half pass out here. Chance of a goal for Kilkenny. Oh, across the goal. Is it a save? Oh, the ball's got into the net and has come out the far side of the net. The umpire has his hand up. It's a goal by Paddy Deegan. Shot out the far side and ended up on the ground, and Kilkenny into a 2-10 to 11 point lead.
That's a massive score, Don. I'm trying to see the replay here because a yellow ball went flying across the goal that I'm just went through the net. You're right. Unbelievable goal that gives 2-10 to 11 points. Paddy Deegan, of all people, to be up the field and after winning a free now as well. Limerick didn't need that, not to be stating the obvious, because things were just weren't clicking. I said in 2018, I saw Limerick's body language after Kilkenny getting a goal. Tom Morrissey, head up straight out. I'm looking at Limerick's body language now. Every one of our forwards has the head down, walking gingerly back into their place. Something serious has to happen. They need to empty the bench. There's green flares going off here. TJ's taking a freeder in the hope he has the distance here, does he? But 2-10 to 11 points, 43 minutes gone, under a small bit of pressure here, Don.
Big trouble for Limerick, 42 minutes gone, as you say, 5 points behind Reid. With the resultant free, is it going over the bar? It's dropping in at the edge of the square into Nicky Quaid's hands, and out here is Dermot Burns. He has David Reedy if he needs it. Just needs to hit the ball. Limerick very sluggish with possession. Back towards William O'Donoghue, and pass back towards Mike Casey. Delivered it long. It's a 50-50 to the brother Peter. Has it in the hand. Tries to take on his man. Fouled it once, almost twice. Gets the shot away. Is it over the bar from Peter Casey? Huge score for Limerick. Much needed. And it's now 2-10 to 12.
Yeah, but just that's the difference. Scoring there against other teams. Mikey Butler was right alongside him. He defended him off. He still tried to get the hooker blocking. Unbelievable score to Peter Casey on the sideline. But I have to agree with you, Don. If we come back from this, it'll be one of the greatest comebacks, even nearly better than Munster final. I was a little bit more optimistic than you were at half time, but things are just going slightly against us now. So Limerick.
Brilliant pass up by Peter Casey towards Barry Nash. Up towards the edge of the D from the former forward. And over the bar it goes. It's now 2-10 to 13.
Yeah, some response to bring it back. 13 points, bring it back to 3 points there, getting 2 points in quick succession. They haven't done that too many times in the whole game, so that'll definitely settle Limerick back into the game. Crowd getting behind them, they know now they need that bit of psychological boost a bit. Body language looking a bit different, they're looking a bit more chest out, and hopefully we can win this long puck out.
Injury to Mike Casey, a worry of course, with Norwich English on the bench. Ball delivered down on top of Barry Nash, puts up the Hurley, bats it in towards midfield where Tom Morrissey half had the ball, then didn't get it away towards Garrod Hegarty, tries to get a gallop up. Garrod Hegarty with a swing and a Hurley, the crowd will roar this one over. The man from St. Patrick puts it over, and it's 2-10-14, 3 in a row for Limerick.
Yeah, I'm shaking my head, I say no Don in that, because what a mentality to have. Most teams would be dead and buried. Imagine a goal. Kilkenny looked really up after the goal. Limerick have to respond with 3 points, effectively after taking it out. Some response, and it's amazing that a goal down this size, the last thing we need is after up in Limerick. 2-10-14 points with 45 minutes gone. This game is back in the melting pot all of a shot.
Certainly is. Two scores between them. Ball down on top of Kyle Hayes. Doesn't win it the first time, gets it the second time. Limerick beginning to win some of the dirty ball. In goes Kyle Hayes, puts in the Hurley, flicks it back towards Barry Nash. Nash thinks it over the top towards Tom Morrissey. He's been on a couple of possession towards Keane Lynch, the wizard of the well, back towards Darrow Donovan around the top of the head. The referee says it's a free, and Dermot Burns will line this one up, I'm sure. And all they're doing is winning the dirty ball, they're going the extra yard. And all, sorry, five of Limerick's forwards have now scored from play. Seamus Flanagan, the odd one out, and he had a sorry enough miss to the left hand side. But as James Ryan says next to me here, 45 minutes gone now, it's 2-10-14. Limerick were in a pile of trouble a couple of moments ago, but they got three scores to respond to that goal. Two scores in the second half so far for Kilkenny. 1-1 they've scored, Limerick so far with 5 points. John Kiley on the sideline, absolutely livid with some of the decisions that have been made, and he's roaring and shouting at William O'Donoghue. And William O'Donoghue says, I've got it sorted here, don't worry, I'll sort it.
Yeah, again, I just can't get over. And you have to compliment Limerick as Don Burns. Yeah, puts it over, fifth point of the game. You can't discredit Limerick and say, oh, they got gifted their way back into this game, like maybe Kilkenny got gifted a goal against Clare, although it was worked right out of him where Clare made a mistake. Every one of the last four scores that Limerick after getting in a row was all out of pure skill, talent, work rate, whatever you want to call it, mindset, but they're after getting the last four scores.
Yeah, Kilkenny motoring again, they're Richie Reid out the far side towards Pádraig Walsh. Walsh delivers it diagonally. Casey stayed down for the ball, was beaten to it. Can Cody get it into his hand? He's trying to, in goes William O'Donoghue, and there's a chance here for Kilkenny to burst in towards Phelan. Back goes Dan the man Morrissey, flicks it away towards Darrow Donovan. Momentum with Limerick, bounces it down towards Barry Nash. Nash in space, he's to deliver the ball, he's turned over, and the ball is into the hand once more of TJ Reid up against Keane Lynch. Two Goliath hurlers going to, oh, once again a slip inside by Cody. Back goes Dan Morrissey once more, picks it up, shifts the shoulder, that's a free out. He's still coming with the ball, he still kicks it out towards Mike Casey. Casey plucks it out in the hand in towards Garrod Hegarty, and away come Limerick, the charge of the Light Brigade out towards Seamus Flanagan, the only Limerick forward not to score from play. The ball's in his hand, he's underneath the Cusick stand, he's bending around, he goes out towards Aaron Galan. Galan says, I'll have a shot from here. I'll tell you one thing, if this goes over the bar, over the bar it goes, and the sides are level at 2-10-16. What a score from Aaron Galan. What a response from Limerick. Phenomenal hurling,
unbelievable score. They wouldn't let the free take quick there, as we see Alan Murphy coming onto the field of play. Actually going on instead of Alan Murphy, wouldn't know much about him, coming on instead of Walter Welch. So Kilkenny feel they have to make a change first. Imagine Kilkenny haven't scored since Paddy Deegan got that goal. Martin Keown, if he didn't trip there, would have been a serious goal chance. Lost his feet. Limerick ended up intercepting the ball. Limerick are on top here. Limerick fans going mad. Now Kilkenny have it all to do against the wind.
Level for the first time since the opening minutes of the game, but this game is far from over, let me tell you. Kilkenny are always worth a goal or two. Out this near side, William O'Donoghue half beaten to it. Referee gives a free to Kilkenny, and TJ Reid and John Kiley have differing opinions on whether the referee was right there or not. TJ Reid delighted with it, John Kiley unhappy. 2-10-16, 40 and it's gone. We're in for a rip-roaring couple of moments here, let me tell you.
Yeah, I don't think they're giving out about the actual free for Kilkenny. I think they're giving out that it was a free for Limerick first. So again, that was a killer of the free, and I think even Mike Reardon, secretary Paul Connacht, were all out giving out about that one, because it's after killing Limerick's momentum. But that was kind of a time where Nicky Quay goes down the whole lot. Kilkenny need this. It's a hard free for TJ Reid. He's on his own 65 on the sideline here to Hogan Stand. Kilkenny really, really need this score, but it's a tough free to put him a point ahead.
Vinny from Brough has been on from Agadir. He says Limerick can do it. Strike from TJ Reid, and over the bar it goes. a score that Kilkenny needed, no doubt. 2-11 to them, 16 to Limerick. Kilkenny in front by one, 48 minutes gone.
Yeah, but Dan, again, what were we, 5 points down after Paddy Deegan getting that goal, and next thing you just get the next five scores. Unbelievable stuff. It's just a shame that we give away that free there, the TJ Reid to kill the purple patch. But now Limerick have the ball again.
Free in for Tom Morrissey. And I'll tell you one thing, if he didn't get it, John Kiley was going to go in and give it to him. Change for Limerick as well. Down below us, the familiar yellow helmet and broad shoulders of Cathal O'Neill about to make his way on, as is the familiar grey fox that is Graham Mulcahy with the jersey off as well. Two big changes to come 20 minutes to go.
Yeah, I think it's only, I think Graham was only giving him the bib. I think Kyle O'Neill's definitely going down with the bib, warming up. Any fella, he took off the training top, so he's definitely coming on. For who, it's very interesting, I don't really know. But look, it's Dermot Burns now in the very same spot as TJ Reid was. He's on the 65, he's got the wind, he's on the Hogan stand side here. Dermot Burns hasn't had a wide yet. Did he hit the first one wide? No, he didn't. He just failed to get the distance, so he hasn't missed one yet. So you'd imagine this goes over the bar to make it a draw with 50 minutes gone.
Hopefully he puts it over, and Dermot Burns puts it over. His fifth free of the afternoon, 2-11 to 17, level for the third time. 6 points for Dermot Burns.
And look, Limerick have the advantage at the moment, because it's although it being a draw game, they have the win. But we all know a win wins the game for no one. But they're definitely after getting to the pitch of the game and intensity level and all that.
Oh, second out of the sky by Dermot Burns, brilliant from him in towards Garo Legaty. Shifts a hard tackle, goes past one man, tries to go past Paddy Deegan, flicks it towards Tom Morrissey. Morrissey dinks it into the corner towards Seamus Fellingham. Bit of space for the man from Fiona Casaman on the 14-yard line. Dinks it, no, tried to get back towards Garo. Instead gives it towards Keane Lynch on the edge of the D. There's Kilkenny men everywhere. Keane Lynch drops it onto the ground, picks it up. Looks like he was half pushed. Gets it back out towards Darragh Donovan. Good wristy striker, Darragh Donovan, the man from Doon. Over the bar from Darragh Donovan, and Limerick in front by 2-11 to 18 points.
Yeah, and that looked like a very easy score for Darragh Donovan to get, but his speed of hand, he ball to hand straight away, and the speed he got the ball, the shot off was unbelievable. And obviously to have the accuracy as well. And again, Kilkenny are running around everywhere now, and Limerick are just finding that pass. Limerick got lucky there, because that ball wasn't meant for Keane Lynch, but fell into Keane Lynch's hand, done very well to keep the ball.
Darragh Donovan has it again. Half blocked as he tries to strike this one towards goal. Galland battling back towards the edge. Brilliant take inside the edge of the square by Hugh Lawler. Kilkenny out towards Pádraig Walsh. What a battle we have between the new modern kings of hurling, Limerick, and the ancient kings of the game. Kilkenny out towards Barry Nash. Pushes past his man. Gets it towards Tom Morrissey. Hand pass inside towards the brother. In towards Tom. And towards Kyle Hayes. And the hand passing out towards David Reedy. Reedy Daglil towards Aaron Galland. Can Galland get the hand on the ball? Galland leaves it beat him. Holding on to the hurling inside. And the referee gives a free to Limerick. They're in front by one. With a free to come.
Yeah, again, great play. But Don, that was the best passage of triangles or whatever you are running off the shoulder. Limerick done out of defence there. They're starting to play with a bit more confidence. Maybe the wind is helping a bit. David Reedy could have went for the shot there. He done the right thing. Well, it turns out to be the right thing now, anyway, in hindsight. Hit the ball into Aaron Glenn. He was definitely fouled by Hugh Lawler. He held on to the hurley way too long. It results in a free for Aaron Glenn just outside the D here to Hogan stand side. We'll be shocked if he missed it to go 2 points up. And the game's, I can't get over after Paddy Deegan's goal. I thought maybe we're under serious pressure here. Limerick have upped it 2-3 gear since.
Only 3 scores in the second half so far for Kilkenny. A chance now for Aaron Galland to put Limerick 2 in front. Would you believe it, after the goal? 2-11 at the moment to Kilkenny. That's 17, 18 to Limerick, now 19. And Galland makes it 3 in a row for Limerick, and over the bar it goes. His fifth point of the afternoon, his third from place balls.
Yeah, and there's a lot of space. Peter Casey's coming out. There's a lot of space inside for Flanagan and Galland. Whether it's the wind helping them or the ball's going in. But the boys are definitely making better runs inside, and the boys are finding them more. The half-backline midfield are finding them more.
Kyle Hayes goes up, doesn't get it the first time, gets it the second time, and Deegan is wrapping the hands around him, and the referee gives a free. He's been consistent about it, in fairness to him. Pulling in a free hand, he's getting a free. Limerick in front by two. All I'll keep saying to you though, James, oh, quick ball taken. Long ball delivered by Dermot Burns. Quick free, and over the bar from play from Dermot Burns, and he bats the hurley and points to John Kiley. And yeah, Limerick now 20 points to 2-11 in front.
You can talk about the game of hurling tactically changing, all this kind of talk all the time becomes very simple. Limerick's half back line are totally dominant, going back to the 50s, 60s, whatever you want. Another puck out Limerick half back line. Every time Owen Murphy's went long in the second half, Dermot Burns have to pluck him to out of the sky. William Dunne's have to win the possession there. They're just killing him in the long ball.
Limerick completely different in the team we saw in the first half, as Peter Casey gets a free out over the sideline, almost gathered inside by Paul Kinnerk and Limerick 3 in front. I actually going to have to try and work this out now, James, while we have a moment of pause. The start of the second half was 1-9 to 11 points. Kilkenny then went 1-10 and then 2-10 to 11 in front. It's now 2-11 to 20 points. Limerick have scored 9 points to Kilkenny's 1 since that
we'll
goal.
Make it 10 now because Dermot Barnes has taken this. He's right on the sideline. The Kilkenny crowd weren't happy now with that free, to be fair. Richie Reid went in. They felt like it was a shoulder to Peter Casey. The ref deemed it as a trip more so. So it ends up being a free on the sideline here between the 45 and the 65. Dermot Burns to take it. Interesting that he usually doesn't come inside the 65 much, but the way he's striking him, you can't but see this going over the bar. And if he does put it over the bar, it'll be 2-12 to 20 points with 55 minutes gone, 15 minutes left, and they're going to go 4 up.
Dermot Burns stands below us in front of the Hogan stand. 7 points so far for him, 6 from frees and 1 from a quick free. 2-11 is 17 to 20. That's gone to the right, I think. Has it gone over? Oh, it has gone over. What a score, Dermot Burns. I'll tell you one thing, they don't hand out hurler of the year to just about anyone. He is the hurler of the year, and 55 minutes gone, 8 points for him. And Limerick with 5 scores in a row now have completely taken charge of this game as Cathal O'Neill comes on for Tom Morrissey. Cathal O'Neill, who has scored 10 points in the championship this season. 15 to go. Limerick 4 in front. Can they keep this up? Kilkenny always worth a goal or two, as we know from watching them down through the years. The black and amber jersey, as I said to you earlier, James, even when it's Gary, whether it's Gary Smilan or Kilkenny, it strikes fear of God in everyone.
I put one of them slightly ahead of the other one, and I don't need to say who. I'm very disappointed there now, to be fair. Probably the one mistake Limerick have made. I know I'm being very harsh, but it's not on the final. Kyle Hayes just with a silly little push in the back there that gives TJ Reid tough enough free, it has to be said again. He's over the Hogan stand side and the sideline, but he put one over here in the very same distance. But again, another score has to come from TJ Reid's stick from a free. They're finding it hard to get scores from play. So look, it just brings it back. He's probably more than likely going to get it. Brings it back to 3 points with, again, 15 minutes to go.
Reid strikes it. And away over on the far side of the field from us, it goes down as his 6th free of the afternoon. So 56 minutes gone here at Croke Park. TJ Reid makes it 2-12 to 21 points. Limerick in front by 3. Up the far sideline goes Cathal O'Neill. Tries to get it into his hand and can't. It's Kyle Hayes has it. Tries to free the body in towards Aaron Gallan. Can't give it to him. Two white helmets going toe for toe, spinning around, and Kilkenny trying to clear it away. Still Gallan chases down his man, puts in the hurley, flicks it away. Limerick now hunting in packs, much like their Kilkenny counterparts did in the first half. Hurley in front of Owen Cody. Ball flicked up over the top though, into the hand on the far side, and Kilkenny have it through John Donnelly, and Donnelly puts it over the bar. 2 in a row for Kilkenny. Back they come. 2:13 now to 21.
Yeah, Donnelly, it's amazing that we're going for 4 in a row. I've done a lot of All-Ireland finals for you with you here. And my heart's beating a lot more than it has. Kilkenny look just won't die away. They're asking the last 2 scores. Good score there from John Donnelly. But this game is going all the way to the end, really, to be honest. It's going to be tight. But Limerick are definitely looking like favourites now, being 2 points up with a strong wind. 2:13, 21 points with, 57 minutes gone.
Yeah, 13 minutes to go. Referee John Keenan from Wicklow, of course, will referee this game. It'll be his last game as an intercounty referee because he has to retire at 50. Ball breaks inside towards Paddy Deegan. He slips and fell into the arm of Cathal O'Neill. The referee says it's going to be a free.
Look, I think it's a very harsh free, but in fairness, Darragh Dunham got one the very same there a while ago, but there's nothing in there. Nearly dives, but maybe we're underestimating, because I'm just looking at the replay here now. He rises the ball, but look, the game is definitely, no, he did, he hit him in the helmet there, alright, so it was definitely freeing. But the game's after taking on new life in the second half, Don. I don't know, is it because it's getting closer to the end, is it more tense? The scores from play, Limerick seem to be scoring a bit easier. The game has had it all. It's a bit like last year's final. So Owen Murphy has a free here. He looks like he's going to just try and go for a point, but it's going to land probably down on top of TJ Reid, who's got Dan Morrissey at the edge of the square.
And Murphy looks like he has the accuracy, but he doesn't have the distance. Drops short. Hurley goes up from Cody, bounces down. Kilkenny always dangerous. The ball edge around the edge of the square, kick towards the post. Nicky Quaid bounces one way. Barry Nash goes over the top of it and out for a wide ball it goes. And Kilkenny aren't happy, but the referee says it's wide as well. And we'll take that one.
So 12. Has to be a 65 redemption for 2019 there.
Nicky Quaid takes the quick puck out towards Garrod Hegarty in loads of space. Hegarty, soft little hands from Hegarty towards the far post. Stop it! Garrone Hegarty, almost anonymous in the first half, knocks over his second score of the afternoon from play, 2:13-22.
Yeah, look, that's a fair two point swing there, because Kilkenny was definitely 65. Kilkenny men took the shot and went out. Limerick fella blocked it, but Dermot Burns and Elliott, an unbelievable third catch again. And again, Kilkenny are finding it so hard to compete there for the long puck outs in their half forward line, or half back line, have been immense in the second half.
Yeah, breaking ball though, out towards Pelly Deegan. The goal scorer gets into the corner towards Mullen. Kilkenny with a chance here to knock over another score, and they do. And it's Mullen's first of the afternoon. And it goes down as 2:14, which is 20-22 points. Limerick in front by 2, 10 to go.
Yeah, and look, I suppose every team has a purple patch, no matter who you're playing, no matter how good the other opposition is. But when Limerick hit a purple patch, they're unbelievable at getting scores on the board. And Kilkenny are after finally recovering from Limerick's purple patch, where they just, what you say, 9 points until Kilkenny's won in that 10-15 minute period.
Sideline balls, Kilkenny coming up, though the momentum shift back towards the men in black and amber at the moment. Three of the last four scores for Kilkenny. 20 points to Kilkenny, 22 to Limerick. Short little sideline ball taken again. Nash goes away from his man Paddy Deegan, struggling a little bit with the legs, and Nash hits this, or Casey I should say, hits this one towards the far post. Unbelievable score from Peter Casey, the man from the Piercy, his second point of the afternoon. Why not score from underneath the stand? An hour gone, 2:14-23.
Yeah, Peter Casey, 2 points, got two outrageous scores from the sideline there in the second half. Good Hegarty, two outrageous points got as well, and unbelievable class out of them two men to get them scores in the second half, and just everything Limerick hit at the moment is going over the back.
Yeah, Limerick looking like they have a little bit in the tank. Here goes Kyle Hayes, the man with the biggest tank of them all. Kyle Hayes from the left hand side, over the bar from Kyle Hayes, and Limerick 24 points to 2:14, 4 in front with 10 to go.
Yeah, and they're starting to cruise there. And it's Limerick that are actually bringing on subs there. Graham Mulcahy looks to be coming on there in a minute, but Limerick on 4 ahead, and outrageous stuff. They're just after opening another gear since I said they upped it 2 gears.
Yeah, Kilkenny under pressure. Keane Lynch has it in his hand, spins away from 2 Kilkenny defenders, gets it back towards Peter Casey. Casey with a short little snappy wrist once more. Has he done enough? Oh, brilliantly caught on the crossbar by Owen Murphy from Kilkenny. 2:14 to 24 points. Limerick in front by 4, ball into midfield. Referee gives the free, and it's a free that David Reedy says nothing to do with me. I was only trying to body check him. Referees,
yeah,
that's a book.
Just before we see the Kilkenny team filtering up into the forwards, you always know, whether it be club, county, hurling, football, whatever it is, when a team's under pressure, they all filter back towards square. Owen Murphy's above, all in his own now. There's no one within, nobody inside the 45 or even the 65 there in general play.
DJ Reid deep inside his own half with the free. 2:14 to Kilkenny, 24 to Limerick. A 4 point lead for the 3-in-a-row All-Ireland champions. This one drops in short, and William O'Donoghue bats it out towards David Reedy. Falls, is going to it, in goes the hand from Mike Casey, in goes Garrod Hegarty, tries to get away from Mullen can't get it into the ground. Still Casey with the hurley out towards Paddy Deegan pushes away from Casey, can't get the ball out, does brilliantly to get it away over the far side, but Kyle Hayes gets the blocking ball up in the air, 50-50 from here in towards Keane Lynch. Limerick moving now with Lynch, tries to shorten the grip and deliver a long ball down towards Peter Casey. He's in front of his man, has it in his hand as well on the edge of the D. Thought about giving it towards Aaron Galan. Instead, he puts it over the bar for his third point of the afternoon. And it's Peter Casey who puts Limerick into a 25-point-to-20 lead.
Yeah, this game is slightly taking on the same role as the semi-final in terms of Galway not playing great in the second half. Kilkenny have to dine out of this second half, and it's pure intensity. They can't match the intensity. Limerick have just upped it, or they stayed at the same intensity. Kilkenny have gone a bit flat, and it's just resulted in an onslaught really in the last 10-15 minutes. And Peter Casey on the ball again,
down towards Peter Casey, out in front again of Tommy Walsh. Casey from away out in the far side, the left hand side. The eye is in. Is it gone over the bar? Oh, what a score from Peter Casey. 4 points for Casey. They're now 6 in front.
Yeah, and I thought Seamus Flanagan would have had a little bit of joy off Tommy Welch, but it's actually Peter Casey that's after doing it. They're after changing Mikey Butler all back over, and Peter Casey there now. Killian Buckley's coming on, but look, 6 points down with 7 minutes to go. It's a tall order. especially the way the momentum is all with Limerick now, as we see Tommy Welch is actually leaving the field of play because he's after being taken to town in a 10 minute period, and was actually going quite well. But Peter Casey got 4 points in playoff in there in quick succession.
Killian Buckley, the man who was married yesterday, onto the field, out the far side towards Cahill O'Neill, takes on his man, trying to get the shot away, knocks it on in front of himself, picks it back up again, still trying to move away. Cahill O'Neill tries to get the score now. Cahill O'Neill towards the canal end of the goal. Oh, what a score by Cahill O'Neill.
Oh my God.
7 points in front. That is glorious hurling. 63 minutes gone.
You can play defensive systems, you can do whatever you like. I suppose we've seen Dublin footballers doing it, going for six in a row, but you can't stop fellas scoring from the sideline. It's impossible. Peter Casey have to do it twice. Cahill O'Neill there with an unbelievable score, and I think that's the nail in the coffin kind of a job done in terms of 7 points. I know you
like
can never say
don't
anything
be saying but, things like that to me. 6 minutes to go, 7 in front for Limerick, 27 points. I was given out at half time they hadn't scored enough, but 1-9, 2-14 at half time. It was 1-9 to 9 points.
Oh my, Killian Buckley's after going off the field. He's literally been on for 1 minute. He's after getting injured himself, which is sad enough. I suppose Richie Hogan's on.
Ball down on top of Cahill O'Neill. Wins the puck out. Breaks away from his man. Advantage being played towards David Reedy from the far side. Underneath the Cusick stand. And over the black spot. Soak it in. What a score by David Reedy. 28 points to 2-14.
Yeah, it's actually... they just can't win a puck out. Again, Limerick done the very same thing as in the semi-final. They just, the half-back line is totally on top, and Owen Murphy give a quick free out to Paddy Deegan there, put him under serious pressure. Kilkenny find the heart to even get the ball up the field.
Yeah, Paddy Deegan, God love him, the legs are gone, I wouldn't blame him. 27 years of age, down towards the man who the legs aren't gone, Dan Morrissey, hand pass across towards Nicky Quaid, takes it in his hand. Limerick 8 in front, 28 points to 2-14. Kyle Hayes bends down and picks it up, and on the far side of the field he has the ever waiting, ever ready David Reedy. Tries to deliver it long, half block down the far side by TJ Reed, but Reedy picks it up again, kicks it on ahead of himself. He's still going as David Reedy, here with Adrian Mullen, still David Reedy, now knocked on towards Barry Nash, who takes over. Adrian Mullen, still Barry Nash, there's still petrol in the tank here as Nash goes high and the referee blows the whistle.
Where is he giving the free ball, is it? Yeah.
Ball all over the sideline. I was getting very excited there, and it's 2-14 to 28 points with 5 minutes of regular time to go. So far so good, James. Just to give you an idea, Limerick have scored the last 6 points in a row. They have scored 9 of the last 12.
I know, but like into the crazy stat, and how can you, like, it's a stupid stat in a way, but Kilkenny would be better off if they didn't get the goal the way the game went, which obviously you can't do. Paddy Dingham went up the field, Kilkenny got a goal at the right time, playing against the wind, just said here we go, and suddenly Limerick kind of, it was the eureka moment where they said, well, let's tune in here, we need to push on. So look, Kilkenny are going to try everything now. They're going to hit a load of high ball in this free. Richie Reid is going to try and lump it in long, but Kilkenny are just at 6 and 7s. They've no...
Tony Sweeney from Lucan has texted us in to say he was here in 1973. He's listed in again. Great to hear Limerick going so well. Kilkenny down below, though, at the edge of the square here. An opportunity, as always, for the men in black and amber to rattle the net. The ball goes out over, almost out over the sideline. Going out for a 65. Tony Sweeney, as we mentioned in Lucan. Thanks a million. Robert Kennedy says, is there any chance you could blow it up before he has a heart attack? I can't help you with that one, Robert. I might have one before the match is over as well. I can't believe what I'm seeing in front of me. 2-14 to 28 as TJ Reid makes his way out to have a shot at goal. 67 minutes gone on the clock. Just to remind you, everyone listening in here, that Limerick are going for 4 in a row. If they do win it, they will join Cork, and Kilkenny is the only other counties that have done so. Cork was in 1941, 42, 43 and 44 before the war. And obviously Kilkenny in 6, 7, 8, 9. And many people will tell you around many taverns of this county and around the world that they were the greatest hurling team of all time. Well, we already know Limerick are the greatest Limerick team of all time. Are they the greatest hurling team? We'll see. TJ Reid knocks over a score. They're first since the 59th minute. 67 minutes gone on the clock. Reid with the 2-15. Limerick with 28 points. TJ Reid, 7 score. All freeze. Here comes Conor Boylan from the Napiershit Club on to replace Garrod Hegarty. And also a change from the Kilkenny team wearing number 18. Killian Buckley back on again. So it must have been a blood substitution rather than anything else. And the puck out to come for Nicky Quay with 2 minutes of regular time to go here in Crow Park. Limerick's lead is 7. Gerard Hegarty minding his hand as he's coming off. Gerard O'Connell got over to have a word with him. And the referee
who
is
went
now
off for Kilkenny there?
Number 12 is John Donnelly. That went off.
Oh, yeah, but he wasn't taken. He's not off yet.
No, he's coming.
but Killian Buckley went down to the field, so yeah, just waiting for John Donnelly.
Stickler for the rules, Jim Pavel, tell you, go down there and have a word with him. We're 7 points clear here, Limerick, looking to win their 12th All Ireland. John Kiley's fifth in 6 years, Limerick's four in a row. I can't even say the words. Puck out down towards Colin Ian. Tries to bat it away from himself. There's Graham Mulcahy on for Seamus Flanagan. Mulcahy spinning around, bats it off the body of a Kilkenny man, referee, linesman on the far side said no. It's a line ball, Kilkenny. 68 minutes gone. Limerick in front by 7. Kilkenny need a goal and they go for one. This time it's through Keen Kenny out around midfield. Gets out towards Reid once more. Long ball delivered in towards the edge of the square. Dan Morrissey's in there waiting. Who's going to get the ball? It's batted down by Cody. Gets a shot off towards Nicky Quaid and saves it. The man from Effick. Out towards Kyle Hayes from Kildimo Palace Kenry. In towards Conor Boylan from Cardavon in the Pearsheik. Tries to get out towards Colin O'Neill. Does it. Back towards Kyle Hayes. Hayes decides to deliver it long once more. Trying to get it in over the head of Paddy Deegan. Into the hand of Peter Casey. Can't get there. And across goes Aaron Gallan. Kilkenny in possession with Deegan. Gallan puts the hurley up. Tries to block it. Gets it in towards midfield and spinning out of the way of the would-be tackle. Here's the newly married Killian Buckley into midfield. Good hand pass now towards TJ Reid. William O'Donoghue chases him down. O'Donoghue still chasing TJ Reid. Reid with the beautiful stick work and a brilliant pass in towards Cody. Oh, what a save by Nicky Quaid. Oh, the referee says come wide. It went off Nicky Quaid's body. I think the hook would have come in from David Reid. What's he doing back there? Limerick in front still by 7 points as we tick towards additional
unbelievable
time.
Unbelievable hook.
70 minutes gone on the clock here. And David Reid, let me tell you, that is a straight up foul. But I don't care.
Additional time, 3 minutes
for Limerick to go, 4 in a row, 7 between them, down towards Peter Casey. Can't win the ball just yet. Kilkenny were never dead, remember that. Colin O'Neill has possession on the ground. In goes Graham Mulcahy. He has it in his hand. Mulcahy thinks about a shot from underneath the stand. Has he done enough to put it over the bar? He hasn't. It's away to the right hand side and wide. I think that's only Limerick's second wide of the second half. Here goes Adrian Mullen for Kilkenny. Long ball chased down by Aaron Gallan into the corner. Here comes Big Dan. Up goes William O'Donoghue. Doesn't win the ball, but neither does his man. Into the hands of Kyle Hayes, starting to grip. Here comes the bomber. Up the field he goes. He's on the ground. Referee says it's not a free. He spun around. I don't know how he still has it. Gets it back inside towards William O'Donoghue, replacing the injured captain that is Declan Hannan at number 6, Conor Boylan. Tries to turn around his man, delivers it into the corner towards his Napiercy teammate Peter Casey. He has it in his hand, does Casey. Is he going to go for another score, Peter Casey? Why wouldn't you if you can do what he can do? And over the bar it goes. And that should be that. 29 points to 215. Unbelievable stuff from Peter Casey. Even better from Limerick. Incredible, incredible hurling.
Yeah, I'm actually in slight shock here, but I suppose tactically there, what did Limerick do? Limerick doing this in the second half, they brought Aaron Gallan out. They said, hey, let's get Hugh Lawler out of there. And they walked the treat. They Paddy Deegan and Mikey Butler inside in the full forward line. Whether Hugh Lawler's after moving out himself now, I don't know. But Peter Casey's after getting 5 points there in the second half. No shot taken at half time. He'd no shot in the board. Unbelievable second half out of him.
Yeah, Kilkenny's still coming down the far side. They won't go away just yet. Limerick in front by 8. Dinked into cords. Cody in the corner. Up goes Mike Casey's hurley. Tries to get it across. Kilkenny's still in position. Falling on the ball on the far side. And away comes Keane Lynch. Keane Lynch bounces it down towards Colin O'Neill, who turns around, beats his man, takes on the second Kilkenny man. Thinks about striking the ball, and he does, down towards a one-on-one. Here comes Gallan, full of energy still, in the last minute of the match. Gallan gets it out in front of himself, tries to flick it away. Brilliant defending in there eventually from Mikey Butler. The referee looks at his watch. Limerick, 29 points to 215, are about to be crowned the All-Ireland champions, James Ryan, for the fourth year in a row.
Yeah, and as bad as they've been going, as we said, they haven't been going as well as last year. They're after winning the All-Ireland semi-final and the All-Ireland final pulling up. After 60 minutes there, this game was over. I know you were saying don't say it, but this game, Aaron Gallan's there taking a free. We're actually,
the game still isn't over, James.
We can enjoy it. 8 minutes or 8 points up and, oh, not far off, wide not ball. But we're gone into the last minute. Even if the Kilkenny go down the field and get a goal, this game is over. Limerick 4 in a row. But the way they turned it on here the last 15 minutes is just outrageous stuff.
Well, we said it at half time. Questions were asked and they were answered. Up goes Dan Morrissey and away he comes towards Kyle Hayes, beaten on the ground there. Kilkenny's still in possession. Down on the far side of the field is Martin Keown, spinning around. They have to go for goals. Gets it inside once more. Beautiful touch by Hogan. Tries to dink it around William O'Donoghue. Hurley goes down. Here comes Mike Casey in towards Keane Lynch, the man that kept Limerick in the game at half time. Back out towards Colin O'Neill in the second half. Substitute throws it onto the stick and over the bar. 30 points brought up by Limerick to 215, and it's Colin O'Neill that puts it over. 73 minutes gone on the clock as Aaron Costello comes onto the field for Mike Casey.
That's an outrageous score again. We talk about tactics, we talk about skill and talent. Peter Casey, two from the sideline. Hal O'Neill, two outrageous scores. Game over. Game over.
Limerick,
four in a row.
All Ireland champions for the fourth year in a row. Absolutely incredible. 3 points down at half time. And win it by 215 to 30. Arguably the best performance of the John Kiley era in that second half. Hammering Kilkenny in the second half. What a performance. And for the second year in a row, they beat the Cats. But for the fourth year in a row, Limerick are the All-Ireland Hurling Champions, James Ryan.
And I don't think anyone can deny this fact. Maybe we're being pure biased, Limerick. If that game went on another 20 minutes, Limerick were just going to go further and further out in front. And we were not saying that after Paddy Deegan's goal. The game just took on. Well, Limerick took on a life of their own. They upped to the gear. And are we saying what we said at the end of all the last three All-Irelands that winning? Are they out that far ahead of the rest? They found it harder now to come out of Munster than they did to win two, to beat the two Leinster teams. They finished Galway and Kilkenny off in the second half. Look, we said the 3 points wasn't that bad at half time. To be down 199 points, but the scoring levels went seriously up. 9 points, they got 21 points in the second half. There you go.
Forget about second half performances, right? Just try and explain this to someone who remembers all the dark days. Four All-Irelands in a row. That Kilkenny team of 06, 07, 08, 09, Tommy Walters and Henry Shiflins. And we have the same.
You can't explain it, because I think, well, anyone that followed all them days where we heartbreak and lose by one, we're still in shock here. Like, I honestly thought we were in for a right battle here. We were up to half time. I was a little bit worried coming into the day. A little bit worried when Paddy Deegan put the ball in the back of the net and they got the second goal. But it just kick-started. They're never beaten. Never set high attitude. And again, just, I don't know, their skill levels, the points they got there in the second half. They just stopped hitting wides. I was very, very worried when Seamus Fanning hit that ball wide there. I said, we're just not at the races. And suddenly just something kick-started and off they went. They're just such a hard team to beat. And it's amazing that Kilkenny had that, and we're after beating Kilkenny twice in a row now. And look, dare I say, not even five in a row is on, because the way they ended that game, I know you're going down, but the way they ended that game, Carl O'Neill, only young fella coming on, Adam English still in the bench, great prospect, Aidan O'Connor, all these fellas, the future's bright and an unbelievable performance.
James Ryan has joined me for tough days over the years, 2019 in particular, if we remember it. But Limerick are the four in a row All-Ireland champions.